Next tonight, renewed scrutiny for college Greek life. There have been three fraternity-related deaths across the country in just the past several days. As 7 Eyewitness News reporter Madison Carter shows us, this all comes on the fifth anniversary of a Williamsville boy's death that has his university asking, would you?
Somebody asked me if there was a point that night where Nolan could be saved. The answer is yes.
A new safety campaign called Would You is launching at West Virginia University with the goal of getting students to intervene or call for help if they see someone in need. Accompanying the campaign comes a documentary called Breathe, Nolan, Breathe. It chronicles the death of Williamsville native Nolan Birch after a fraternity hazing incident 5 years ago when he drank too much alcohol.
I was angry, and maybe still am a little bit, at Nolan. I was like, come on, kid, you know better than this. What in the world happened?
Birch's doctor said he could have been saved had someone stepped in. Nationwide, universities are increasing regulations for Greek life, but year after year, hazing deaths keep occurring. Here at home, the University at Buffalo completed a four-month review of Greek life and released new recommendations in August. This comes following the death of 18-year-old Sebastian Serafin Bazan at an off-campus frat house. Neither police nor the university have commented on whether it was related to hazing.
Students are reluctant to report hazing, both in and out of organizations. That continues to be one of the challenges that universities and other organizations face.
We did reach out to UB for an update on how the new regulations were impacting Greek life this semester, but no one was available to speak with us. Buffalo police tell us the case is now with the Erie County District Attorney's Office. We're waiting to hear back on a request for an update on the investigation. Madison Carter, 7 Eyewitness News.